Good morning to one and all. In the previous class, we discussed about the super elevation curves and different kinds of designing of the super elevation. That means the different terrains, rolling terrain, steep terrains, and other terrains, how we have to design this super elevation curve and different methods of design. In these different methods of design, the first one we are designed about this elimination of a crown method. That means normally this crown is kept for draining of water purpose. So in this method, by implementing this crown like structure, one side totally disturbance will be occurred due to stagging of water, so that we need to avoid this crown like structures, especially in constructing a super elevation curves. So that we need to use this kind of method by rotating about one edge only. That means either by its inner edge or outer edge. That means whenever the vehicles are moving in a circle, we need to put constant on one edge. That means inner edge we are putting constant, simply we are raising outer edge, so that this crown shaped adjustments will be done. So that these are the advantages and disadvantages, as previously we had discussed, to mainly eliminate this drainage problem. By this problem also we are having a drainage problem on one side only, but in case of another these crown like structures, we need to face drainage problem on either side of the road. But in case of these one like structure, that means rising method, we are having this drainage problem on single edge only, so that the disadvantage should be decreases. So that in the second method, we need to rotate the only one edge. That means with respect to inner edge, we need to rotate outer edge as most as possible, depending upon the load and the frictions. That means the amount of load would be traveled on those particular roads, and friction between friction, that means totally friction between the tire and the pavement of that particular kind of vehicles traveling on those roads. This is the diagram representing the rising of inner edge with respect, rising of outer edge with respect to inner edge. Simply we are having central line, and E is the amount of rise with respect to central line to outer edge. In this problem, we are advantages is no drainage problem. That means the total water should be drained from road to other side. That means there is no stagging of water on either side of the pavement, so that the total water will be drained into another way by using, say, small canals nearly behind the roads. In the national highways and other structures, we will observe these kind of small canals. That means whenever there is a rainy problem on that particular area, the total water will be drained by using those small canals, and those water will be drained by using these sinkholes. So generally the sinkholes are constructed to increase the groundwater levels, so that rainwater can be sinked into those sinkholes, so that automatically groundwater also improves. We're having different kinds of advantages also by using these kind of problems. And the main disadvantages is earth filling. That means we are having a rise, so that the rise will be filled by filling materials like different kinds of industrial wastes and surrounding waste materials which are non-degradable. That means whenever we are using these filling materials, we have to use a non-degradable materials. That means manaki earth lo kalisipovunnatundi materials, whenever there is a usage of degradable materials, there will be a humus and peat like this material. So there will be humus and peat. That means those are useful to grow different kinds of plants and vegetation on the roadsides, so that the entire mass should be used to develop the trees and plants. Okay, the entire mass will be converting into trees and plants by giving some amount of voids between that means manaki road surface kinda ee oka material motham kuda manaki in the form of trees and other vegetation, so that voids will be formed behind the road level so that after the passing of vehicles those voids will be filled as a sinks and that means manaku gunthala form avutu untadi that is the main advantage of using these non degradable wastes degradable wastes those two next one center line of the pavement is also raised vertical alignment of the road is changed that means whenever there is a curves suppose in the previous class I discussed these curves C curve that means in the C curve only we use one type of rising that means inner edge is constant outer edge will be raises but type of S curves on one side inner edge will be raised another side outer edge will be raised in this side only inner edge but in case of this side outer edge will be raised so that different kinds of risings are there this is the problem vertical alignment will be changes due to its property of the alignments and vertical lines after that we are having these curves radius of horizontal curves previously we discussed that the total radius of horizontal curve depends upon this elevation that means e equal to elevation and next one f is the friction e plus f equal to v square by gr so that the total amount of elevation and friction those two things depends upon this velocity of the vehicle and radius of the curve those things we need to calculate here g equal to 9.81 after substituting g we will get this as v square by 127 r if the minimum stresses and that means minimum elevation and frictional values as per IRC we are having 7% of minimum elevation and we are using 0.15 as a friction value so that this value becomes v square by 127 r equal to 0.22 why because 0.07 plus 0.15 by adding those two values we will get 0.22 by equating those 0.22 into 0.22 to v square by 127 r we will get this v square by gr after that this value will be changes to terrain to terrain previously we explained different kinds of terrains steep terrain rolling terrain hilly areas we are having normally different kinds of terrains due to those also we need to modify our existing plans to convenient plans that means manaki previous ga tayar chesina plans nu prakaram mottham kuda manam convenient ga depending upon soil strata and other conditions raised in the sites we need to plan according to those so that we have to plan these radius for rolling and minimum values so that v square by z of e plus f equal to this value so that r equal to e plus f total radius will be depending upon this elevation plus friction r minimum also we are having this formula v square by g of e plus f very so both these rolling terrains and minimum values we are using the above formula v square by gr why because e plus f are equal to 0.22 after that we have to explain those terms where e equal to super elevation the primary letter in the elevation is e and the primary letter in the friction is f so that we are denoting those two terms with e and f after that we are having velocity in terms of meter per second and kilometer per hour kilometer per hour we are showing with kmph with capital v and meter per second we are denoting with small v that is the difference between small v and capital v after that we are having g value g is the acceleration due to gravity which is equal to 9.81 meter per second square after that we have to discuss about this widening of pavement on horizontal curves what is widening that means enlarging the this is the normal curve we need to widen after that we need to decrease for particular span this is the widening of the widening this kind of widening along the horizontal curves to eliminate these kind of optimum flight distances and other conditions on horizontal curves, especially when they are any less than 300 meters of radii. That means less than 300 meters. That means nearly less than half kilometer. It is a common to widen the pavement slightly more than the normal width. That means normal width means there it is a single lane. We need to provide a 3.75 meters as a width for that particular road. For suppose if the horizontal curve is less than half kilometer, that means 300 meters, we need to enlarge somewhat because of these elevations and other ruling terrains and others. Widening is needed for the following reasons. Why? Because this widening is needed for different kinds of reasons. Those reasons should be explained in the below term, below paragraph, by using different conditions. Those conditions we will explain. An automobile has a rigid wheelbase and only the front wheels can be turned. But the what we are discussing is an automobile, that means for a four-wheeler or two-wheeler, any other vehicles, we are having front wheels and back wheels. Those two are moving, but we have control on only front wheels. So we don't have control on back wheels. That means the steering or any other for two-wheeler or four-wheeler is movable. Those steering is attached to only front wheels only, so that we have a command on front wheels of any vehicle, either it may be a lorry or any other. We have only command on front wheels only. Due to turnings and others, so we have to move those front wheels by using these handles and the steerings. If the rear wheel is do not follow the same path of the vehicle of the front wheel, the phenomena is called tracking. That means whenever we are having a curve, we need to rotate our handle or steering. If the handle of the steering is rotated, automatically front wheels will be moving and up, and as well as back wheels also follow the same gradient what we are maintaining on those road. That means if the front wheel is moving, automatically back wheel also has to follow particular amount of turn. If there is not a turn, that means automatically our vehicle will be skidding at that particular point, at what point we are applying this steering movement. That means mana vehicle meeda travel avutu unnapudu mana vehicle yokka edaina sudden ga curve anedi vastu untundi. Aa curve lo mana em cheyalante mana vehicle ni aa curve taggattu mana smooth ga run chestu undali. మన యొక్క బ్యాక్ వీల్స్ ఫ్రంట్ వీల్స్ రెండు కూడా ఒక ప్రాపర్ అలైన్మెంట్లో యొక్క డిజైనర్స్ అనేవాళ్ళు డిజైన్ చేస్తూ ఉంటారు. ఆ డిజైన్కి తగ్గట్టుగా మనకి ఫ్రంట్ మనం ఎప్పుడైతే మన స్టీరింగ్ని రొటేట్ చేసామో, ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఏ స్లైట్ మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్ వీల్స్ ఆల్సో హ్యాస్ టు బి మెయింటైన్. దట్ మీన్స్ దోస్ టూ థింగ్స్ హ్యాస్ టు బి ఇన్ వన్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్, అదర్వైజ్ ఆటోమేటికల్లీ వెహికల్ విల్ బి ఓవర్ టర్న్డ్. దిస్ ఫినామినా దట్ మీన్స్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ట్రాకింగ్. ఈ ఫినామినా అంటే మన ట్రాకింగ్ అని కూడా అంటారు, ఓవర్ టర్నింగ్ ఆర్ ట్రాకింగ్. నెక్స్ట్ సెకండ్ పాయింట్ ఈజ్ వెన్ టూ వెహికల్స్ క్రాసింగ్ ఎట్ ఓవర్ టేకింగ్ ఎట్ హారిజాంటల్ కర్వ్, దెర్ మే బి ఏ ఫిజియోలాజికల్ టెండెన్సీ టు మెయింటైన్ ఏ గ్రేటర్ క్లియరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ద వెహికల్ ఫర్ సేఫ్టీ. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇన్ ద ప్రీవియస్ క్లాసెస్ వీ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ దీస్ ఓవర్ టేకింగ్ సైడ్ డిస్టెన్సెస్. ఇన్ పర్టికులర్ ఓవర్ టేకింగ్ సైడ్ డిస్టెన్సెస్ వీ నీడ్ టు మెయింటైన్ a proper enlargement length compared to normal length. That means for a single lane road, we are maintaining 3.75 as a minimum width. But in case of these overtakings and curves, we have to maintain sometimes 4 and 4.25 to these conditions, overtaking of vehicles and other conditions, so that horizontal curve, the physical tendency to maintain a greater clearance between the vehicle to safety. That means greater distance. The minimum distance between the vehicle to vehicle is simply we are keeping 1 meter. In such cases, we need to maintain a greater distance, means suppose 1.5 and 2 meters. If we enlarge like this, automatically width of the pavement will be increases. Automatically, the cost of the project will be increases. So that we need to do some proper investigations while designing and while keeping these super elevation curves and horizontal curves. And next third point is the greater visibility at a particular curve, the driver has tendency to not to follow the central path of the line, but used to see outer side of the bearing of the curve. That means whenever the driver is moving on a particular road, that means whenever we are traveling in a single lane road or double lane road, we need to follow
some conditions so that the road maintenance team, they have maintained some amount of these gradients like central line and edges. We are having these different kinds of painting. By using those paintings, we need to maintain a proper way without any zigzag pattern. We need to move a straight pattern by using our vehicle. Otherwise, the front coming vehicles and back coming vehicles has a different phenomena on the vehicle, so that there may be a tendency to jamming or any over or any crashing of vehicles occurs. So that we need to move in a particular perpendicular path whenever there is a road is a straight condition. If there is any curving conditions, we need to move in an arc shape with the our transporting vehicles. That means but the users also outer side of the beginning of the curve, that means outer side of the beginning of the curve, whenever we are moving in a particular length of the curve, we need to maintain in a proper way. That means in a single way we need to travel. We didn't have to overcome one way to another way, another way to this way. That will create a lot of confusion to the road users, and there may be a chance to skidding due to these centrifugal forces. And the next point is that higher speed of super elevation and lateral friction can't contract these centrifugal forces and skidding may occur. This is the main point we are discussing from first class and others. At higher speed and super elevation and lateral friction, that means whenever the vehicle is moving with a higher speed on that particular stratum, that means profile of your road, there may be a lateral friction can't contact the centrifugal forces. Lateral friction, that means the friction between tire and pavement. This is the tire, this is the pavement, there may be some friction F value. If the vehicle is moving with fast condition, that means there is a less contact area between tire and road strata, there may be a chance of occurring accidents in high level. So that we are having a contact of centrifugal force and the skidding may be occurs. So that they tells us skidding may occur. That means skidding whenever we occurs, we are having less amount of friction. Suppose when we are walking on a particular road, if the road is filled with completely water and or any other humus materials, there may be a chance of skidding because of there is less friction between our feet and that road. So that the total body will be not maintaining particular center to that road. Automatically we will collapse on that particular road. So that same phenomena will be applied on the vehicle whenever it moving with a higher speed on that particular stratum. Whenever it is a higher speed, that means there is a less friction between this tire and pavement, so that the total body will not be concentrated on a particular road, so that there may be a huge amount of chances on skidding of vehicles due to less amount of actioning of these centrifugal forces on the particular body. Next, analysis of extra widening of horizontal curves. In what way we need to analyze how much amount of earthwork will be needed, how much amount we need to enlarge the particular road, what is the factors affecting on those enlargement criteria. That means whenever we need to enlarge a particular surface, we have some physical principles. By using those physical principles and other derivationals, we need to follow some formulas and others. We need to formulate by using those formulas and different kinds of values we need to form. After those, we need to substitute those lengths and widths and radiuses. We will get a particular amount of value for the particular gradients and lengths. So that we need to analyze in what way we need to go, what are the different factors acting on those particular analysis part. By using those analysis, in how much advantages are there, what is the disadvantages are there. By using advantages, what we can get. Disadvantages means how to overcome those disadvantages in different patterns. First of all, to extra widening of a pavement on horizontal curves, it is divided into mainly two criteria. First one is a mechanical widening of the track. That means mechanical widening. That means some important mechanical formulas are used to widening these pavements. Next one is the physical widening. That means physical widening. There is no some physical formulas and mechanical formulas. Those two formulas are used to improve the extra pavement while the road having horizontal curves. Those things we need to study here. First one is that this is the mechanical widening. That means in the mechanics of any structures, simply we resolving the forces by using different kinds of arcs and others. The mechanics we are having basically drawing is a core structure subject. For mechanics, drawing is a core subject. For physics, the core subjects are mainly, the core theories are mainly this tans and other tangents theories and other equations, physics. So that first of all, in the mechanical widening process, we need to form the particular pattern of the road. That means in a what pattern we are having the particular road and what is the amount of length we are maintaining, what is the width of the road, what is the elevation of the road for normal criteria. After that, we need to analyze what is the extra amount of road is required for that particular horizontal curve. For the particular road, first of all, we need to mark the center point of the road at the edge. That means in the inner side of the road, we need to maintain a particular center point. That means O is the center point for that particular road, is make it inner edge. That means inner edge means low elevation we are having. After that, we need to choose two points, A and B. A is the bottom edge and B is the top edge. By using those, we need to formulate two radiuses. That means inner radius and outer radius. In the bottom side, we are having huge amount of radius compared to top side, because in the bottom, the total length is high because there is a triangular pattern. Triangular pattern, we are having huge amount of base. So that we are having A, B, and we are A, B, okay. From that A, B, the minimum length we are maintaining, that is 1, okay. After that, there is some point, that means extra widening we need to require. What is the extra widening? This is the basic diagram. Here they are explaining the terms. OA is the radius of the path transversed by the outer rear wheel. OB is the radius of the path transferred by the outer wheel in meters. Outer front wheel, that means rear wheel and front wheel, that means in the inner edge we are having rear wheel, outer edge we are having front wheel. That is the basic difference. WM is the mechanical widening due to off-tracking force. L is the total length of the vehicle in terms of meters. R is the radius of the distance. So that we need to have mechanical widening term WM equal to OB minus OA, that is equal to R2 minus R1. From using this triangle formulas, that means OA square equal to OB square minus BA square, where OA square equal to OB square minus BA square. How it comes? From triangle OAB. OAB means in the triangle OAB we are having hypotenuse side square plus side square. Okay, this is the formula. In this diagram, OAB, that means hypotenuse is the OB is the hypotenuse. Okay, here I will write OB equal to hypotenuse. Okay, what is the basic formula for triangle? That means right angle triangle we are having is hypotenuse square equal to side square plus side square. So that OB square equal to OA square plus BA square we are having. Simply we are applying here OB square equal to OA square plus AB square. By transporting BA to other side, we will get OA square equal to OB square minus BA square. As per the diagram, we are having lengths of OA. Here we are having OA is the R1, OB is the R2, and BA we are having length of L, that we are keeping here. That means L equal to length. So that, but R1 square equal to R2 square minus L square. But R1 equal to what we are having means R2 minus WM. Simply substituting in R2 minus WM, that means WM is the mechanical widening what we require. Substituting in the R1, R2 minus WM whole square equal to R2 square minus L square. Simply the total formula in terms of R2 and length
you will get Wm easily. R2 square minus 2R Wm equal plus Wm square equal to R2 square minus L square by eliminating R2 square and R2 square. Okay, that means R2 square having positive sign on both sides. R2 square will get off R2 square and R2 square. After that, we are having Wm square minus 2R Wm equal to minus L square. We will transpose Wm on other side so that L square equal to Wm of 2R2 minus Wm. Okay, this is the by multiplying simply with minus on both sides, we will get L square equal to Wm 2R2 plus minus Wm square. So that L square equal to Wm into 2R minus Wm. After that, we will calculate Wm equal to L square by 2R, because the mechanical widening is so small compared to total length of the road, so that if the minus sign we are calculating is negligible, so that they consider Wm equal to L square by 2R. It is the formula for mechanical widening. All those formula can be depends upon only simply a triangle. Okay, all those formula simply because depending upon this triangle, which is the O A B R1 R2, this is the L. Depending upon this triangle, the total formulas will be come. That means O A equal to R1 square, O B equal to R2 square, and B A equal to L square. By using those trigonometric principle, we derived all the mechanical widening of the road. Okay, simply we will take off this derivation easily by remembering this triangle. Only outer edge is what is inner edge, what is the minimum length of AB, R1, R2. Okay, this is very easy for everyone. If the road having n traffic lanes, that means for single lane we are having only single lane, for double lane we are having two lanes, likely we are having n lanes, we need to multiply with n into L square by 2R. That is the width of the mechanical widening required for extra pavements whenever there is a horizontal curve. After that, we need second, first one is the mechanical widening, second concept we have having is physiological widening. That means physiological widening, in empirical formula we are having recommended that as per designs of IRC from first class onwards, we studied that the total roads and their layouts can be prescribed by the IRC. That means Indian Road Congress. They implemented a huge number of books and rewritings on the transportation systems available in India, and what are the preventive measures we have to take, and what are the conditions, site situations, different studies and different impact assessments, all those are given in this IRC codes, so that we need to follow those. And in some cases we need to remember those for GATE and other APPSC purposes. The physiological widening has given some formula. Directly they are given, there is no derivation to this physiological widening. Only we are having mechanical derivation, we are having mechanical widening, we are having simply a triangle with OA, OB and AB equal to L, OA equal to R1, OB equal to R2. By triangular principle we have found out the mechanical widening formula, WB equal to L square by 2R for single lane road. For n number of lanes we are having NL square by 2R. Likely physiological widening we are having WP. In mechanical widening we are denoted term with Wm, that means widening in terms of mechanical. Here we are maintaining widening with terms of physiological rules, so that WPS we are having what is V equal to simply velocity of the vehicle, 9.5 square root of R means radius of that particular curve. Simply we will remember. In total extra widening is given by WV equal to Wm plus WPS, that means mechanical widening plus physiological widening. Both terms we need to calculate for extra widening of the road. W equal to NL square by 2R, that means for n number of lanes, L square is the, L is the length of the road, that means size of the rising. L square by 2R plus V by 9.5 plus R. So that N equal to number of lanes, L equal to length of the wheel base. Sorry, N equal to length of the wheel base. That means wheel base, normally wheel base is maintained as a 6 meters. That means 6 meters means this principle is considered for lorries and others, so that it will be easier to cars and other conditions. There is designed for a lorry, that means the total weight is so much compared to these cars and others, so that it is mainly depends upon these lorries and other conditions. Huge number of trucks we will design, automatically simple vehicles will travel easily on these conditions. L equal to length of the wheelbase, that means length of the wheelbase, you are simply confusing what is the wheelbase. I will show, this is the back wheel, this is the front wheel, this is the length of wheel base. Okay, length of the wheel base, the distance between the two successive, that means front wheel and back wheel, the distance is called length of the wheel base. This wheel base is different for different kinds of vehicles. For suppose there is a tractor, for the tractor we are having totally three lanes of tires, that means in front side we are having small tires, in the middle side we are having huge amount of big tires, but in case of back trolley we are having somewhat less than the middle sides, so that this wheel base will be different for tractor. But in case consider lorry, for the lorry also we are having some kinds of lorries having only two trains of lanes, but in case of some kinds of lorries we are having three wheels on one side, that means back tires we are having double tires with three bases, but in case of car we are having only two bases. Like the different kinds of vehicles having a different wheel bases, we will consider average wheel base as 6 meters here. That means length of the wheel base equal to 6 meters for average vehicle. By considering all those considerations, we will fix this average wheel base L equal to 6 meters. V equal to design speed, that means whatever the design speed of the particular roadway, if it is a super that means expressways, the wheel speed is 120 kilometers. National highways we are having 100 kilometers. Like that, different kinds of roads, the wheel base mainly depends upon these kind of way what they traveling on those particular medium. And R is the radius of the horizontal curve, that means radius of the horizontal curve. This is the total curve, that means one side of the road, another side of the road. This is the main diameter, this is the radius. Okay, this is the one condition. In another case we are having this is eccentric condition, so that we are having a huge amount of radius here, huge less amount of radius here, less amount of radius here, so that we are having different radius conditions. On those particular case we are getting average radius of the particular curve, we are taking as average radius of the particular curve, we will take it as R, so that we will care extra widening equal to NL square by 2R plus V by 9.5R. Okay, this is the widening of the road. Once again I will explain this widening of the road. This widening is entirely comprises into two conditions. First one is the mechanical widening, second one is the physiological widening. In the mechanical widening, we will consider only these mechanics principles. So by using this simply triangle and what is the radius of the curve, that means the radius of the particular road and outer radius and inner radius and minimum height of the pavement. By using all those three conditions, we will encounter the formula. This is the terminology what we are using in this particular diagram. What is OA, what is OB, and R is the minimum radius of the horizontal curve. By using those, we will tabulate the some particular principles. By using this triangle OAB, by using this hypotenuse theorem, side square plus side square equal to hypotenuse square. Here we are having side square plus side square equal to OA square plus AB square equal to OB square. We are simply transporting OA BA square on another side, we will get OA equal to square equal to OB square plus BA square, R1 square equal to R2 square. by previous diagram we will get this R1 is what, R2 is what. After that we will get mechanical widening in terms of L square by 2R. It is for L square by 2R for only single lane roads. But in case of multiple lanes, we will multiply with N as lane number. That means one way, one, two way, two, three way, three, four way, four, like that. How many number of lanes we will multiply with N term. After that, we are having physiological widening. Physiological widening, okay. This WPS is the, W means widening with respect to physiological principles. So that we will discuss with the WPS. That is the velocity and radius. Mainly depends upon velocity and radius. That means physics, we are having only velocity. We are considering, not with all other terms, velocity and radius. So that we are considering velocity by 9.5 or by recommended by the Indian Road Congress. After that, we will combine these two widenings, mechanical widening and physiological widening, for WV, that means enlargement of the widening, equal to NL square by 2R plus V by 9.5R. This is the total enlargement of widening, today's topic. Next topic is entirely varies with this today's class, so that it will be discussed in the next class.